That's him. That's the guy that says 54321. Uh-huh. Just before you hear that music. Hey, hello everybody, and welcome to Larry's Country Diner. We're going to have a good time today. I'm going to get my tongue straightened out. Right now, I want to introduce you to a guy who always dreamed his name would be in lights. Never dreamed it was going to be on the side of a diner, but here's Larry.
That's good.
Yeah.
That's good. That's good. All right. Promise time. Lick the finger. That's better.
Yeah.
Matthew 5:8. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God.
I'm in.
You're pure in heart?
I'm pure in heart. Oh, you of disbelief.
Let us be the judge of that. You know, we believe in healing.
Yes, absolutely.
Bubba goes to the pastor and says, Pastor, I need you to pray for my hearing. Pastor says, okay, praise for him. And he said, how you hearing? He said, well, it's not until next week.
Oh. I think the sheriff was involved in that case, wasn't
it? As long as I'm being stupid. Mm-hmm. Two antennas met on a roof, fell in love, and got married. Ceremony wasn't much, but the reception was excellent. Boom, boom. Number 92.
Let's think about the hooping and the hopping and the bopping and the loving.
Who is that?
Bob Lubin.
Big Bob Lubin.
Not you.
Oh, I'm sorry. Bob Lubin.
112. Anybody know from that? Who said that? Chuck Berry. All right.
Can you do the Chuck Berry?
You like boots?
Yes.
I have a $100 gift certificate from Boot Daddy for you. Give that to her. All right. How about number 236? Yeah. Brothers.
Yeah.
I just learned how to pronounce that.
That's all right.
Did he do it?
It was going to be Malpass until somebody walked up to me and said it's Malpass.
Well, we've been called everything. Some people don't call us at all.
Yeah, we haven't called you in about 240 something shows.
That's right. That's right. I'm glad to be here too.
Now I understand that man right there produced a record on you, or was in a session with you when you were in your early teens.
Yes, sir. I was actually 12 years old.
You weren't even a teenager yet.
No, sir.
He sang great even then too.
Well,
he sang Peach Picking Time in Georgia.
Oh, is that right?
He's just saying that because we paid him really good for the show.
I started to say,
well, that was part of it.
That sounds like one of them money deals to me.
All right, so we got Chris and we've got
Taylor.
Taylor.
Yes, sir. Some people call me Taylor. You can call me whatever you want.
Call him Taylor. Well,
you said Tyler, and it come out Southern.
Yeah. Well, people always ask us two things. Is that really your hair? And do you really talk like that? I'm afraid both of them are real.
Yes. I love it. Let's see if you really sing like this.
Okay, well, we'll do one. This is one we wrote, and it's one entitled, I Found Someone to Love.
2, 3, 4, 1.
I found someone to dream about, someone to wish day in and out, to always be here by my side, to love my heart forevermore, to never walk through cheating's door. I found someone to love, even though she don't love me. Even though she don't feel the way I feel deep inside, even though she don't want me near every day and night, even though she would be happier if me she'd never seen, I found someone to love, even though she don't love me.
Mr. Jimmy Cass, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes.
back too. I know that I just fool myself, all dreaming of a future. No love light ever shines in her eyes. It matters not what she may think, my feelings, they remain the same. I found someone to love, even though she don't love me. Even though she don't feel the way I feel deep inside, even though she don't want me near every day and night, even though she would be happier if may she'd never say, I found someone to love, even though she don't love me. I found someone to love, even though she don't love me.
Yes, sir!
Good stuff. Woo. Chris and Taylor. Oh, it's Taylor. I thought it was Tyler.
Tyler. Yeah. No, the accent.
Not Tyler.
Yeah, the accent's really, really strong.
You're very confused for a man that's got it right in front of him.
Well, I know, but when I heard it, I wrote it Tyler. I'm sorry.
I don't.
My girlfriend will really get a kick out of that. So.
Now she'll start calling you Tyler.
Well, the problem was that was her last boyfriend's name.
Oh,
oh,
oh.
Awkward.
I like you guys.
Well, yeah. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. We're glad to be here.
You've been doing it forever. You have.
Yes,
how about
sir.
With?
I started when I was 10.
Him.
I started, yeah, him. That guy, that's good. 10, him works. I started when I was 10. I'm 26 now, so.
Wow. 16. We've been always with him?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. We've always done it together. For years, we traveled around to little churches doing the Living Brothers style music, and then we just sort of, it grew and grew, and we've been very lucky to get to work with people like Don Helms and Mr. Merle Haggard for 7 years, and we just had a lot of blessings come our way. So,
the offerings kind of petered out at the churches, huh?
Yeah, well, yeah. Well, you know, it's it takes a lot of money to keep this hair up.
I believe it. What kind of moose you use, anyway?
It does look like a holiness preacher, but it still takes a lot of money. So.
They're going to have a whole new act when he goes bald, you know?
Oh, boy, it's going to change things, isn't it?
You know that.
Okay.
Oh!
Fun fact.
Fun fact. You're going to like this one. You're going to like this
one. I'm ready.
I think somehow you know about this. You may not know the figure. On average, a car driver will swear or blaspheme 32,025 times in their lifetime while driving.
Swear or blaspheme?
Yeah.
Well, I'm not going to swear. What's blaspheme?
That's when you say things you shouldn't say.
Like you silly, no good for nothing, rotten idiot.
Well, no, I wouldn't think of that.
So that doesn't count?
No, blaspheme, I think, is when you take the Lord's name in vain.
Oh.
You ought to know that.
Well,
You don't really do that, though.
No, not even in a car.
It's just like, woo, 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 woo.
I welcome them. They're just doing their jobs.
32,025.
Speaking of a job.
I bet Homer's done that once or twice.
Hey, Nadine. What's going on, woman? There you are.
How you doing?
I'm doing good. How you?
Ooh, we got young blood in here today.
Yeah.
Young blood.
Young blood.
Do, 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 do.
What kind of volumizer are y'all use?
It's strong, I can tell you that.
I need some of that. Mine's flat as it can be.
No, it looks good.
Wasn't like for the hatch, you wouldn't have any head at all,
right?
Really.
I wouldn't. I wouldn't. There's just a big knot under there. But I like that hair.
Thank you.
Y'all from North Carolina. Who's got a new baby?
I do. Yes, ma'am.
I saw that baby.
He's 7 months old, boy. Aww. Yes, ma'am. Yeah, we're spoiled.
I like the way you talk.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Do you ever watch?
Because I can't lose it. I've tried.
Did you ever watch Sling Blade?
Yeah.
Yeah. I sure did.
I love that show. I love it. Well, I'll tell you something. I'm just an old woman. I was back here in the back searching for my phone for 15 minutes using my phone's flashlight.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Some people ain't gotten that
now yet. I'm watching some people out here, and they've all done the same thing.
Yeah. Senility is a smooth transition, ain't it? Well, I don't understand why I remember every word to every song from 1959 and can't remember why I walk in a room.
Yeah.
I don't understand that. But, I got a whole lot of problems. I don't know how many I got because mass one of them. But did y'all know that 4/3 of the population have problems with fractions?
Four-thirds
of the population cannot do fractions.
Present company excluded, right?
Yep.
Four-thirds.
I was looking at
Keith. I just got it. That's funny.
He's from Alabama. No, Emmy, Joe, and Keith was riding down the road the other day in Franklin. They called me. It was at nighttime. They called me and they said, Emmy, Joe, his wife says, hey, there's a crowd over here at the funeral home. Do you know who's here?
Yeah.
She's always, doing that. And I said, no, I don't know who's there. So we got on the obit line. We got an obit line and checked it out. And it was one of Homer's buddies. Yeah. We didn't know that. And so we got dressed and went down there. And He was a good guy. He was a good guy. He was happily married. His wife wasn't, but he was.
She's a lot happier now.
Yeah, a lot happier now, yeah. And we're standing there, and one of Homer's friends is looking at him. He said, staying looks good, don't he? I hate that. That's why I'm going to be cremated. Ain't nobody going to be looking at me when I'm dead. But anyway, he said, staying looks good, don't he? And you know what his wife said? She said, well, he should. He just got out of the hospital last week. And then my husband's brother, Clyde, he comes over to us and he's talking. He said, he looked at me real serious. He says, you know what? You know, when you're dead, you don't really know you're dead. It's just hard on others. I said, yeah, Clyde, like when you're stupid. I said, Lord, don't judge people by their relatives, please. I'm going to go and put a sign up.
What's it going to say this week?
It says, stars cannot shine without darkness.
Ooh. Oh, that's good.
That's deep, ain't it?
It is. Yeah. That's heavy.
Stars. What was that again? 4/3 of what?
4/3 of people have problem with fractions.
I got it now.
I can tell you, you're one of them.
Yep. It's like a jumper cable walks into the bar. The bartender says, I'll serve you, but don't start anything.
Oh. Oh.
Well, I just left Nadine. I mean, those things just kind of come out of you, Ned. How do we get the Malpass Brothers product?
Well, you can go to malpassbrothers.com, our website.
Golly.
We took a while to think of the name, but we kind of battled around on it and decided to come up with the name malpassbrothers.com.
Big decision, I can tell.
But look now, all joking aside, you can't get them in Walmart because we can't.
That's right. Get them there.
Now, this one says Hag Records, Inc.
Yes, sir.
And you mentioned Merle Haggard a little bit ago. Did you travel with him?
We did. From about 6 or 7 years, we opened for Mr. Merle Haggard, and we were on his record, Hag Records.
Wow.
He was like a second father to Taylor and I. He was very good to us. And
wow.
We owe a lot to Mr. Merle, that's for sure.
Incredible. I'm just looking at some of the songs you got here. Which is the most recent one?
That one, yes, sir.
This one?
That's on Organic Records, and Mr. Doyle Lawson produced it. He's producing all our records right now. So
a Marty Robbins song, a Willie Nelson song, a Bill Anderson song, Bob McDill, Hank Williams. Great songs on here.
Thank you, sir.
What you going to sing for us now?
Well, one of our biggest influences were the Leuven Brothers, and one of Taylor's biggest guitar influences was Mr. Jimmy Capps. I mean, he is obsessed with Jimmy. I think Jimmy's nervous being this close to Taylor. He's obsessed with Taylor. But Taylor, we're going to do a song that Taylor learned this from watching Mr. Jimmy play this with the Leuven Brothers on YouTube, and we'd like to do this, and I'm going to say y'all are very privileged to have one of the best musicians in the world
up here.
So how about a hand for this?
Yes, we are.
So this is one called I Can't Keep You in Love with Me.
It must have been an awful hurt someone did to you. The bitter nor the sweet. I can't find my way around your wall of memory. If you want me, why can't I keep you in love with me? You say you're mine and I'm not blind. I know you want to be. And when you're way to lose would be to listen and believe the lies they tell to you. There is a way you can repay the one who let you down. Let me repair your broken heart. Don't leave it on the ground. If you want me, why can't I in love with me? You say you're mine and I'm not blind. I know you want to be. And when you're holding me, no sweeter love could ever be. But when I'm gone, somehow I can keep you in love with me.
Fine.
Take a break. We'll be right back.
All right. Well, you've heard of the Hat Act. We've got the Hair Act today. Malpass Brothers. Right after this.
Good stuff, guys. Great.
Welcome back to Larry's Country Diner. Diners, I noticed a lot of you are through with your food. We've got a special today. The Malpass Brothers old-fashioned ice cream sundae, whipped topping, your choice of chocolate or strawberry.
I like that.
Slick your hair back and enjoy it. Here's Larry.
He's bad.
He is, man. I'm jealous is what I am.
You got plenty of hair. You can do it.
I know, man. I can't get it to stand up like that.
Put you some mustard on the side of your face when you go to sleep,
uh-huh,
and them sideburns will pop right
just
up.
Pop right up.
They sure will.
Gray sideburns.
Gray
sideburns. Malpass Brothers. Aren't they good?
Yes.
Yeah.
Loving it.
Give us another one.
Well, we'd like to do one. We mentioned that we worked with Mr. Merle, and as you know, we just lost Mr. Merle Haggard, and we'd like to do one to kind of pay tribute to him, and this is one of my favorites entitled In My Next Life.
Oh, yeah.
One, two, three, four.
The blood-red sun beat down and baked the red clay ground. Dust kicked up around his John Deere wheel. No trace of rain in sight. Again, he'll lose the fight and have to watch his crops die in the field. They stood there, both in tears. His wife of many years said, "John, you know, I hate to lose our farm." He looked into her eyes, then he looked up at the sky, and he told her as he held her in his arms, "In my next life, I wanna be your hero. Something better than I turned out to be. I've lived this life behind the plow and harrow, but in my next life, I'll make you proud of me." The muscles in his arm, just like his rundown farm, soon withered up and slowly disappeared. One hard-working man, two hard-working hands, were giving up after all these years. His aging eyes grew dim as the woman who worshipped him sat crying in a chair beside his bed. Her hand caressed his brow. She said, "It's all right now." And as he slowly slipped away, he said, "In my next life, I wanna be your hero. Something better than I turned out to be. I've lived this life behind the plow and harrow, but in my next life, I'll make you proud of me. In my next life, I wanna be your hero. Something better than I turned out to be. I've lived this life behind the plow and harrow, but in my next life, I'll make you proud of me. 'Cause in my next life, I'll make you proud of me."
Yeah.
Good man. Stuff. I need to get a microphone over here to Max so we can, well, give it up. No. Max Davis from Possum Holler Garage is building our
you wagon. You call it a car.
It's not a car.
You've been calling it a car for a year. It's actually a panel truck.
It's a panel truck.
Right.
And it's a gorgeous panel truck.
Yeah, it's coming along pretty good.
Is it going to be ready?
It's going to be ready. We're going to be ready. When that grand opening happens, uh-huh. We want all the folks from all over the country to come see the panel truck. Don't worry about the diner.
That's right.
And all the food. One thing, I'm glad to be here because it's a good feeling to know that I won't have to eat for 3 or 4 days when I leave here today. And another thing is, those guys can really sing. And I'd like to get a record.
Thank you. Yeah.
They didn't pay me to say that. I'd like to get a record or a CD somehow, and I'll listen to that. I can listen to that when I work on trucks.
There you go.
Because, you know, you got to get in that right frame of mind.
So are you working on trucks other than ours now?
Oh, man, we're building trucks just like Tartar builds the farm stuff and Gus builds chickens. You know, I build trucks.
Anything in that box I'm supposed to know about?
I got something from my good buddy Keith Bilbrey. Folks may remember from a few episodes ago, he was complaining about carpenter bees. So I got him a carpenter bee house.
Carpenter bee box.
Yep.
Yeah.
And it's still got some bees in it.
Oh, I can use
and
that.
And the reason I left them in there is to show you that it really works.
Yeah.
So the carpenter bees go into that hole? They don't have to make one?
And those things, I found out that they like sweet tea. So you could take some sweet tea and put on there and just hang it up and watch them go in, and it's like...
Will the diner sweet tea work?
Yeah, so all the leftover tea...
Is that for Keith?
This is for Keith.
Oh, wow, thank you.
And the bees are dead, so you don't have to... Emmy Joe don't have to worry about going to hospital.
Well, how about that?
Yeah.
So...
I like that.
Happy birthday, Merry Christmas.
What's that big clump in there? What is it?
That's where...
Oh, that's sweet tea.
That's toilet paper left over.
Yeah. Oh, I got it. I'll hang that up.
Anyways,
patio.
Don't want to forget, you know, PossumHollerGarage.com, Facebook, Possum Holler thing, Mr. Jim Carter, OldChevyTrucks.com, where you get all the parts for these panel trucks and old trucks.
It's a good-looking truck, guys.
Yeah. Everybody needs to come out and look at it.
Welcome back to Larry's Country Diner featuring the Malpass brothers. That, you know, they do remind me a lot of the Lubin brothers, Jimmy. I wonder if they fought like Ira and Charlie do.
I don't think so. I don't think anybody could fight like that.
It's Larry.
Did you guys follow the Wilburn brothers? I mean,
Taylor and I worked for about 2 years with Mr. Don Helms. And so we did do some Wilburn Brothers stuff as well because we're huge fans of them too. Mm-hmm. So we've done a lot of the brother duets. We tried, you know, doing some of the sister stuff, but it just didn't work out. But Taylor did shave his legs for the part. But we are huge Wilburn Brothers fans, yes, sir.
See, if it had the last name Swift, it'd have been all right.
It'd have been fine. You're exactly right.
Tyler Swift.
That's right, Tyler Swift.
You're exactly right.
Just completely get it wrong.
I got to have you do this. Chris, could you just give me a golly?
Golly!
I knew he could do it.
We do have a thick accent, that's for sure. But I'm glad to be from the country.
I'm glad.
And I tell you something else, too. I'm glad that I figured out. I've often wondered where them bees came from. And now I know that they're not Yankee bees because they got sweet tea.
That's right.
They got to be from the South.
With a little lemon sprinkled in.
That's right. Malpass Brothers, I am so delighted that Terry Choate said to invite you guys.
Well, thank you, sir. We're very honored to be here. It's an honor to be here with you and Mr. Jimmy and Miss Jean Shepherd. Makes it kind of hard, though, to sing with people like that in the room with you.
So it doesn't, but Keith and I, you don't care.
Yeah, well, no, I'm y'all too. Y'all too. Yes,
just checking. Give us another one.
Well, we're gonna do an old Hank Williams song. This is kind of a fun one called "The Long Gone Lonesome."
Oh yeah.
I went down to the river to watch the fish swim by, and when I got to the river, so lonesome I wanted to die. But the doggone river was dry. She long gone, and now I'm lonesome blue. Now she told me on Sunday she was checking me out. Long about Monday she was nowhere about. Hey, it is Tuesday and I had no news. I got them long but not forgotten blues. She long gone and I'm lonesome blue. Couldn't be true. Married me for my money and she made me blue. A man needs a woman that he can lean on. While he ain't in poster done left and gone. Gonna find me a river, one that's cold as ice. And when I find me that river, Lord, I'm gonna pay the price. So Lord, I'm going down in it three times, but Lord, I'm only coming up twice. She's long, long, long gone, and now I'm long on some blue.
Yeah! Woo! Son!
Mamma mia!
Thank you.
That's great.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
You don't have another song, do you?
Well, we can maybe come up with something.
Do one.
What you want to do, Tater? That's all I mean.
You want to do When I Stop Dreaming?
Sure, oh, yeah. That'd be great. All right with you, Mr. Jimmy?
Yeah, love that song. All right. Jimmy may know it.
I think he probably. Yeah.
For some reason, I feel like he might remember it. Well, actually, we're going to do something with guitar because I don't have a man on mic.
Oh, you don't have a mic? Well, you can put it down and sing with me.
I'll do it the old-fashioned way.
We're doing hey, Mr. Jimmy.
Okay, that's fine.
When I stop dreaming,
yeah.
That's when I stop loving you. The worst that I've ever been hurt in my life. The first time I ever wanted to die was the night when you told me you love someone else and asked me if I could forget. When I stop dreaming, that's when I'll stop loving you. Oh, Jimmy Caps now. Unwanted in spring, alone and neglected, transplanted in vain to a garden of sadness where its petals would fall in the shadow of undying.
Malpass Brothers, yes.
Thank you.
Check them out on malpassbrothers.com. Thank you guys
thank
for coming.
Thank you, sir.
Great. Yes, get us out of here.
I feel
we got
like
go.
Grant Turner coming in after that one. Hey, thank you for joining us. I need one more thing if everybody can help us. Larry's Country Diner, where the cameras are always rolling and
we don't care. All right. Good stuff. Good shows. Thank you.